So this is how Mahamaya plays. They had planned everything. They had all the arrangements made and the sari was missing. All right. So they came and told me that the sari is missing. So now what to do? You can't have puja without the sari, according to them. So I said, all right, let's wait. If it arrives in time, we'll have it. Otherwise, we can have it later. But I was least disturbed, least upset, because I do not have a mental conception of it. But if you have a mental conception, oh, we have programmed everything, arranged everything, we have done this, and now it's fizzling out. Doesn't matter. Nothing is fizzling out. But that is what we cannot do. Because you asked me today what is Mahamaya, this is what it is. You must learn to accept whatever comes your way. That's one of the things. And here where we feel frustrated, angry, upset, and spoil our joy, one of the things. Because we make a mental projection. Mentally we calculate something. This has to be. And it's really in a way a subtle ego failing. Because I thought that's what is destined, all right, we'll have it tomorrow. What does it matter? In any case, I told Mr. Srivastava that I'll be back only about 2 o'clock. He said, why not in the morning? I don't think it will be feasible. So, this is how you become a Vyagra. Vyagra means person who is worried, the one who is not worried. So we worry because of 2 things. Firstly, we worry that what will happen in the future? Future doesn't exist. If you have made up your mind that this should happen in the future, then you get upset. That's one thing. But you have not any mental picture. You will see what comes on the scene. You will watch whatever appears. Then you are not worried because you are anxious to see what's going to happen. That's one way that you feel hurt, that or you are worried. Secondly, you worry when you have built up a picture of that, oh, we are going to have a puja now, and we are not having. So you are upset. But what difference does it make? And then you cannot enjoy my talk today and the puja tomorrow. Because today you think it was going to be puja, we are all dressed up well, very nice. We spend so much time to get ready for the puja, all right, we can do it tomorrow also. What does it matter? We really decorated ourselves well, we were all ready for the puja, we were sitting here for the puja, and now what has happened? I didn't wear my sari for puja at all. I knew what was coming. So, it's all right to see you like this, because normally in the puja I never see you dressed like this, I'm busy with myself. Now I can see you nicely dressed, I feel very happy about it. And these mental things are responsible for frustrating us. Like, as I was telling you about money, same thing happens. In India people come, they keep so much money for buying things. You see, sometimes they come loaded just like what you call traders. The customs are so kind, I mean, Sahayogis have a free pass, whether in India or in England or anywhere. And then they have a mental picture, we'll buy this. Right? And so much we spend. And if they have to spend some money for something else, they get upset because they have decided to spend so much. So then they went go to spend some money. That's also, you see how Mahamaya works, you see. It has happened with all of you. So they go and buy something. I'll tell you, Gavin bought once an image. I don't know, he paid about, I think, 500 rupees. You know, how much have you paid? About 4,000 or I don't know. How many pounds you paid for that? Huh? 40 pounds. He paid 40 pounds for that thing. I would not even pay 5 pounds for that. And I said, what's this? How did you buy? Oh, it's a very nice thing, Mother. We got it in Agra. I said, it is from Nepal. If you buy it in Agra, it will be very expensive. And it's such a waste. But the worst was the vibrations were very bad. They thought they have bought something great. And the vibrations were very bad. And I noticed it, so he said, all right, Mother, I'll keep it in your house and you improve the vibration. I tried, it would not work out. I said, Gavin, what to do now? You sink it in the Thames. I don't know what to do. And then luckily it happened. Sipi said that I have to take some present of Buddha, Japan. I said, these Japanese exhibitors are good for nothing. No booth is going to trouble them. So he said, can I buy something? I said, Buddha thinks it's not easy to get here. But I have an Avalokiteshvara, would you like to take that? He said, what is the price? I said, 40 pounds. He said, all right, I'll buy it. And he bought it for 40 pounds. I said, all right, give it to this Japanese fellow. He was a very nasty person. I said, good for him. And I palmed it off. That's how. You see, because I knew that it will have some purpose somewhere. So this is how our mental images are so rigid that there's no flexibility in our understanding. And if you start making it flexible, then, and this is very early stages when Gavin had gone to India, very early stage. Now he is different. So if you become flexible, then what happens? You see the joy of it. You see how things get adjusted. But if it is rigid, then you get caught up into your own rigidity. And you can never enjoy it. Because there's no movement for the Mahamaya power. And that's how then you feel frustrated. You see, it is all your own creation. The mental projection is your creation. And also the destruction is your creation. Nobody is responsible for that. You are responsible. But who does that is Mahamaya. Sankalpa vikalpa karoti. You do decide something. You say, now, today I will go to Birmingham. I have to go to Birmingham. I can't come for a meditation. I have to. After some time you will find that it's impossible to do something but to do what is needed for surgery. Because whenever you will try to do something, you'll find it will frustrate you, it will upset you. If not, then it will make you realize what is important, what you are missing. Sometimes you get lost on the way. You think that, oh God, we have lost the way, what to do, now where to go. If I was you, I would say, all right, you've lost the way, must be to find something else. And there I find something else, which I've been looking for days together. I just see that. So, if you trust your joy-giving quality of your spirit, that you are not going to lose that quality of the spirit at any cost, then that acts as a guide. And you understand the flexibility of all these worldly transitory things. They are all changeable. Only you cannot change because you are the spirit.